Pumping Iron Day 45. It is swim meet day. Got the swim bag. I'm gonna try and get a lift in afterwards, but I think the gym's gonna be closed. Maybe I'll just do some push-ups or something like that. But anyway, try and get some of my races. And yeah, it should be fun. It's at UCLA. Swimming 50 breast, 50 fly, and 100 breast. Yeah. So a bunch of like California teams, Stanford, Cal. Yeah, we're going there. Some other big schools. So should be pretty fun. It's the last meet of the semester, and it's my first meet in 4 months. So it's gonna be challenging, to say the least, but no pressure compared to my other meets. And you know, I think everyone really there is just happy to, you know, swim. And you know, I love the team, and yeah, we're gonna have a good fat. Tomorrow we have our end of year party, which is supposed to be really fun. So, you know, looking forward to that. But anyway, for the lifting part, it is leg day. And, you know, we're just gonna have to see what happens with how the schedules line up. Don't know how it's gonna work. But I've said this before, if you make it your utmost goal to get to the gym, you're going to get there. So that's what we're going to do. Maybe it'll be a pull-ups, 100 pull-up challenge or 200 outside. But I'm gonna get some workout in. And not to say that swimming's not a workout, but I'm going to pump some iron. That's what the series is called. You know, I guess we can talk more about that. Right. I've said this multiple times. It takes 45 minutes to get a lift in. So why aren't you lifting? You know, people have all these excuses about busy schedules and, you know, not having energy. It's all the same excuse that you've heard a million times. It really comes down to discipline and, you know, doing something when you don't feel like it, which is a pretty good definition of discipline. And I can say that, you know, I don't feel like going to the gym. You know, some days, I'd say most days I really like to, I'm looking forward to it. But there are days, you know, when I just don't want to, right? Where I feel so, where I feel like when I came back from Yosemite, right? Like, that's probably the most tired I've ever been. I had pink eye. I still went to the gym. And I felt better afterwards. Because that's what happens. You do feel better. You feel better if you're sick, you know. Now there are some instances where you shouldn't go. Maybe I shouldn't have gone that day that I had, you know, pink eye. And got back and I was really tired. But I just think that really helped me get back, you know, on track, schedule, and ready to go. You know, one lift you miss can't hurt, but one lift often leads to another, which leads to another, and you get the point, you know. So, try not to miss any, and, you know, I try not to miss today. I'd say a little out of my hands, but then again, I mean, I'm living my life, so most everything is up to what I put in. That goes for everyone. You know, obviously there's some external things you can't account for. But, you know, if you prepare enough and have a compelling goal to do something, no matter how much, you know, external things are thrown at you, you're going to find a way. I mean, there's just so many ways to do things. First, it's just when people say, I can't do this because of something outside of their control, you just gotta say, and you know, make it inside of your control or find a way around that, you know. But you know, anyway, about up to the swimming pool, so I'll see y'all there. Thank you.
Thank you.